So we'll do the range test, 120 kilometers per hour on the Autobahn. Hmm?
Perfect.
What you say?
Perfect.
And you will also join us, or what?
Perfect. Let's go.
I don't know why Tesla actually doesn't offer aero wheels for the 20-inch wheels. That would be really not much work. I mean, you just have those 20-inch caps and you snap it onto the rims, you know, like with the 18-inch aero caps, it's the same. You just snap it onto the rims and you can put them off again. So I don't know why they don't offer this option for the 20-inch performance wheels. Would not be really difficult for them to make them, and would the air drag would reduce by about 5%, so I would not mind 5% more range, honestly. Actually, we're driving to my parents and then we'll drive back again, so it's a total trip distance of around 160 kilometers, so 100 miles. So it should be quite
representative.
Exactly. It's looking good. So, and start. Let's take a look at our consumption meter. We kind of managed to hold 120. Kind of managed to hold 120. So it says now we have driven 16.3 kilometers and now it says 179 watt hours per kilometer. 179 watt hours per kilometer, 16.7 kilometers driven at around a speed of 120 kilometers per hour. Not bad. You're doing this pretty nicely.
Thanks a lot.
You're driving quite efficiently. Yeah, it's not bad if you drive a bit fast, because we have also stretches where we drive slower. Driven 61 kilometers and our average consumption is 173 watt hours per kilometer. And as you can see, we really try to drive 120 plus minus 20. So from 100 till 140, but on average 120. And that's quite nice, I would say, because that means a range of more than 400 kilometers at this speed. And we have even the AC on now. So 410, 420 kilometers at 120 kilometers per hour is freaking amazing. I cannot stress how freaking amazing this is. It's like, it's wow. acceleration, right?
Yeah, because we started the car. Mm-hmm. We started the car.
Hmm? What?
Everything's fine.
Yeah.
So now let's see how the graph moves.
Yeah, and how my efficiency is now is pretty bad because we're driving uphill, you know? And I had to accelerate. And
we can also recognize from this bar here, if it's to the right side, it means you're consuming a lot of energy.
Yeah.
You're accelerating a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, during the day you see it's black on the right side, but now we are in the dark mode.
Yeah.
It's not dark outside, so it's white.
Yeah. And should I use the autopilot, by the way?
It's up to you.
Let's try. Autopilot engaged. What's that? Magic.
Can you set the speed to 220?
I tried to set it to 120, yeah.
So here's maximum speed for the autopilot. This is the speed the autopilot tries to keep. So we expect now that our energy efficiency increases for the autopilot because it's kind of, I mean, thanks to the software, it should be the optimal efficiency, right?
Yeah.
We assume that the autopilot can drive better than me, for example, that it doesn't unnecessarily, that the autopilot doesn't unnecessarily give too much gas or brake out.
That's true. So it's kind of relaxing in these traffic situations.
Yes.
The autopilot, I have to admit, is kind of relaxing. So when there's a lot of traffic and dense traffic, in my opinion, the current version, at least, is, in my opinion, not good enough. Because the lane changes are very, very slow.
But now we only have two lanes and not so many cars on the road.
Yeah.
So it's quite nice. So the autopilot did the lane change now, right?
Yeah.
We just indicated it does direction of the
exactly
language.
But still my energy consumption is brutally higher than yours
because you're going up here.
I didn't think that it makes such a huge difference. Like, I didn't know that Munich is so far above sea level compared to Abensberg. What the hell's going on? Approaching the end and I cannot make it below 190. I just can't because I don't know, it's like it went uphill and
after the uphill stretch you managed to go down to 180 on average.
But it's still more than on the way there. It's weird. It's still more.
You think only that part was
uphill? Like,
afterwards it was not uphill.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that this is the reason. I mean, we drove very similar speed-wise, in my opinion. There was not much difference.
Yes.
We always tried to go 120 on average, and I have no idea, but this is the only possible solution, that Munich is higher elevated than Abensberg, and on the way there we were driving downhill, and now on average we're driving uphill. That is the only solution I have. And I think it's the right solution. Now we have to stop the test. So we are at 189. 189 watt hours per kilometer. We've driven 68.1 kilometers. And yes, that's... So we had on the way there 170 watt hours per kilometer, right?
Mm-hmm.
On the way back, let's say 190 to make it a bit easier.
Yes.
We're at almost 190. So on average, we had 180 watt hours per kilometer, which is just perfect because that gives exactly 400 kilometers of range.
Yes.
right?
It's far enough.
At a speed of 120 kilometers per hour, and don't forget, we had the AC on the way there, yes. And now we have the heating on.
Yes.
So it's it's very nice. 400 kilometers of range at 120 is really, really good. Hope you had fun also, right? And yeah,
so see you next time.